tree at my guitar, now I shall sing. On hearing which our mind is free, that heart receptive to God's word becomes the Lord, our is abode. On the wheel of change, a man is turned until Sri Atma Gita is heard. Even the place in which it is sung becomes a sacred place of love. Or sing this song each day. True understanding thou wilt gain, and all past sins will fade away. Will fade away. Will fade. This song is dead. Sri Krishna out of love bestows a place on high, and those who give this song as gift are one. the one conscious self is forever the same. Therefore, Uddhava, cling fast to the self. Your mind must be steady, unswayed by the world. Your heart must be free of all selfish desires. If you wish to awake and to know who you are, when you have gained knowledge and wisdom as well, when you can feel one with the whole universe, when you have found the self and in self found delight, then you though you live still on earth, thus will you go beyond evil and good, without pride or you'll see not but one, and in one keep your mind. O Krishna, my God, only soul of the world, so that I may awake, please instruct me still more. My mind is so dull, I'm unable to see the way that a man from this flesh can be free. Listen, Uddhava, take refuge in me. Perform all your duties and work faithfully, but keep your heart free of all want or desire, and surrender your heart and your mind unto me. This world which the senses perceive is a dream. There is nothing within it that is what it seems. So keep your mind steady, remembering me, and do what you must. The motive of pleasing oneself leads only to ruin and darkness within. But works that are done in the service of God bring freedom and peace. as the fruits of the world. With your mind wide awake and remembering me, surrender all thought of yourself and be free. Give up the false dream of myself and my own. Become one with God through devotional love. Regard all your brothers with equality. See only oneself in whatever you see. With all doubts dispelled by the bright light of truth, awake from the dream of this world and be free. When you have become free of all worldly desire, no power can shake you or move you to higher. Unstirred by the words of both good men and Java, be free, keep your mind fixed on God. O Krishna, all men are aware that the world is changing and fleeting, a whirlpool of dust. Yet see how all men run to fill their desires. See how they are caught in the jaws of dark lust. Though suffering and misery ruin those men who seek for their pleasure the objects of sense, please tell me, dear Krishna, why should it be so that men like dumb beasts love their suffering so? Uddhava, such poor men do not know the truth, nor have they the peace and contentment that comes from knowing the bliss of the one conscious self, pervading this world. The self is body and mind and the organs of sense, betrayed by desires of the flesh, they are led by dreams of sense pleasure to giving himself to the impulse of lust. A foolish man gathers up pain for himself. But the man of dispassion and knowledge is wise. He gathers the fruit of a joy that's divine. So listen, Uddhava, give up lethargy. Keep watch on the thoughts of your mind faithfully. Withdraw your regard from the world and its play. Remember the self with each thought every day. This which is known as the Yoga Supreme. I've taught it to gods and I've taught it to men. I'll tell you, Uddhava, the words which I gave to the great sage Sanaka in a far distant age. The question Sanaka asked of me was this: the mind is attracted to objects of sense, and objects of sense become fixed in the mind. How can I be free from sense objects that bind? What you say is true, I assured him at once. But you are neither mind nor the objects of sense. There is only one I, ever free and divine. When you know that self, then true freedom you'll find. That vision which sees many where there is one is asleep though one's eyes may appear open wide. The one conscious self is the reality. Awake from the dream of this world and be free. Dispel the dark clouds of delusion with truth, with knowledge and wisdom. Shed light on the self. Realize who you are, and by knowledge be freed. Devotion to truth is the true love. Today the world like the forms of the clouds in the sky. It is but one consciousness seeming to be. The manifold world which the senses perceive. Withdraw from this world of appearance your mind, and give up the thirst for the pleasures of life. With the mind set at rest, know the bliss of the self, and nevermore fall into error's strife. That man who has tasted the bliss of the self may move among objects of sense without fear. His mind never clings to the world's misery. His heart is with God, and his soul is made free. This is the secret which Sonika was taught. The goal of all men and the highest of paths. Give worship to God as the self of your heart. See only one self and remain unattached. Krishna, the sages have taught many ways to reach to the end of man's journey to God. I wish to know, Lord, the way that is best. Can each of these paths be as good as the rest? Uddhava, my child, there are many ways which sages have shown to attain the supreme. The pathways are many, but each of them leads to the knowledge of God. Beyond scriptures or creed, by love or by inward control of the mind, by faith or by wisdom, by serving mankind. All these have been taught as the way to reach God. But the best way of all is devotion. Joy does one find in the sweet love of God? The bliss of his love fills the whole universe. Madhava delight, that Lord who is within. Surrender your life in devotion to Him. As wood is burned up when it's thrown into fire, devotional love burns up worldly desire. By study of books, men may try to find joy, but God, who is love, is found only through love. Without love for God, all men's learning is vain. It is only through love that true bliss is regained. With joy in his heart, that wise lover is blessed. Who serves God with love, it is this path which is best. Uddhava obtained that sweet blessing of grace by taking the path that is followed by saints. Give worship to God through devotional hymns. Perform all your actions in service to Him. Be free of all selfish desires of the mind. Renounce everything for the love that's your mind is surrendered and evermore true. That love which is bliss will awaken in you. This goal is the highest goal one can attain. God's freedom and bliss in the form of a man. All pleasure, all knowledge, all power divine belongs to that man who surrendered the mind. So therefore, Uddhava, restrain the desire for outward enjoyments through organs of sense, and turn your mind inward with love to the self. Through deep meditation, retain your true well. Learn to be even in mind and in poise. Be calm in the midst of the mightiest storm. Though men may upbraid you and call you false names, remember the Self, remain ever the same. Do not allow hatred to rise up in you, nor ever in anger
blow for blow.
But keep your mind turned to the sounds within, and strive to be free from the bondage of sin. O Master, dear teacher, O soul of the world, when one is insulted and false words are hurled, how hard is the task of remaining in peace? Please show me the way I can do this with ease. Indeed, it is true, there is nothing more hard. The words of the wicked strike deep in the heart. Like arrows they lodge in the breast of a man, and cause such a pain that he scarcely can stand. But please let me tell you, Udava, my child, a story of one who is painfully tried by torment and misery throughout all his life, yet ever remained free of pain and of strife. This man was once wealthy and foolishly proud, till fate intervened and deprived him of all. But the blow fortune dealt him was good in disguise, for he soon realized where man's real treasure lies. With mind turned within, he examined his soul while wandering the earth as a sadhu alone. Though poor in the eyes of all men of the world, he soon became wealthy in true self-control. Now other men saw him alone and detached, and decided to test him by treating him rough. Wherever he went, he was treated with scorn, as men tried to wound him with words and with stones. But though he was treated by all men with spite, the truth of the self he kept ever in sight. Tormented incessantly, injured and wronged, he sang in his heart this pain-dispelling song. No pleasure, no pain can affect my true self. Both suffering and pleasure belong to the mind. The self is the witness all the mind's play, remaining forevermore conscious and free. The self, like an object reflected in glass, appears to be mine and the whole universe, and man by forgetting his identity is lost in delusion and knows misery. All teachings of sages have one common goal. They all teach the way to attain self-control. The highest religion consists of justice, to bridle the mind and in truth become fixed. The uncontrolled mind is man's sole evil foe. It vanquishes men with its weapons of war. Forgetful of this, men see evil in men. Like fools they forget that all evil's within. None other can cause me to know joy or pain, for I am forever the unchanging one. The sense of delight or of sadness I find comes from the false notion that I am the mind. The body and mind are both subject to change, but I am the one. Forever beyond shame or fear, the sweet blissful self in the one I hold dear, the one I hold dear, the one I. That was the song that my wise wanderer sang. Though injured and tortured by wrong-hearted men, he held to the truth and continued in peace, and crossed o'er the ocean of misery. When you can surrender in full love to God, you'll rise to the heights of the heaven within, in blissful awakening you'll know your true self, and fathom the depths of the whole universe. And when your mind's light becomes steady and bright, all ignorant notions will fade out of sight. The false sense of ego will then disappear, and the world of appearance will bind you no more. Your mind will be peaceful, absorbed in the self. You'll look on all others with equality, beyond good and evil, with ego dispelled, to nothing attached, you'll then become free. What more can remain to be gained by that man whose heart is filled with love, who's found joy within? His words are of truth, that all men are made pure. By hearing from him of the one who endures, like fire he is able to burn away sin and light up the deep night of darkness within. A blessing to all, he is like a strong ship to carry all men across this ocean to bliss. As food sustains life, and as life sustains man, that sage who is free is the savior of all. The sun in the sky who lights heaven and earth cannot be compared to that sage who lights hearts. Now let me tell you, Uddhava, my son, the things you must do with the truth to be one. By following this you will come to know bliss. Through wisdom you will conquer the invincible death. Awake to the knowledge that God is yourself. Let all of your actions be guided by Him. Surrender your life in the service of God, and your heart will be filled with the light of His love. Take up with the holiest saints, those sages whose lives are devoted to God, and learn by their conduct to live as you must, to see only one in this vast noble Uddhava. Your sight must be pure to see only God in this manifold world. Such vision is wisdom that sets the soul free. See only one consciousness incessantly. By seeing in all men the Spirit Divine, the notion of others abandons the mind. Realize this one truth, and your heart will be free of anger and hatred and mean jealousy. That man who has seen God sees God everywhere. He worships the Self in all hearts as his own. best mode of worship in me. To treat all as God in one's thought, word, and deed. Such is the knowledge I pass on to you, by which in this life you may learn to be free and lose all attachment to things passing by, and know your true self as immortality. Dear brother, said Sutta, the tale has been told of Uddhava and Krishna in days long ago. Fountain of nectar which flowed from the lips of Sri Krishna enables all men to know bliss. I bow to that Krishna, the one soul of all. This song at Nikita, his glory has poured. All men win freedom by singing this song from the Srimad Bhagavatam Purana.